This dendrite, which grows inside of your battery, can lead to two major issues. First, it reduces efficiency. It consumes the liquid electrolyte inside of your battery, and this directly reduces capacity. Because they're metal, they can form little wires internally inside of the battery that can short-circuit the battery. This can lead to significant safety concerns, such as formation of fires, etc. Lithium ion, while it has really accelerated our use of portable devices over the last two decades, is reaching its fundamental limit. However, if we move to lithium metal electrodes, we're able to increase this capacity by a factor of 10. This means that your battery can store 10 times as much charge for the same weight of the electrode.
So imagine a world where in one single charge of your battery, you can go from New York to Denver without ever having to stop to refuel. These are all very real realities with next generation lithium metal batteries. However, in order for lithium metal batteries to become a commercial reality, dendrites are a problem that have to be solved by the research community.
Most battery research is performed in small coin cells, which are actually metallic encased batteries. We make them, we plug it into a cycler, and we see how much energy can we move back and forth. As you pull it apart and look inside, that doesn't truly reflect how it behaved when you were actually charging and discharging it. In order to gain deeper understanding inside of the battery, we literally created a window to be able to look inside.
We call it a visualization cell, we shorten it to vis cell. The materials that are used in lithium metal batteries are incredibly reactive. We actually have to bring them into this glove box, argon protected environment where no moisture or oxygen is present. This prevents any side reactions that can lead to explosions or fires. We just don't want it to blow up. That's true, we don't want it to blow up. Once the visualization cell is completely assembled, we can then do imaging where we can actually take high resolution videos of the surface and actually look at the different battery components while they're being charged and discharged. Nobody has been able to take high resolution video images of what is happening to the electrodes and link that with what is happening electrochemically to your battery.
We now are able to detect the origins of why dendrites form, where they form, and how this depends on properties such as how fast you charge or discharge your battery or other usage patterns. People have known for a very long time that dendrites are a major challenge. This enables us to understand why they form and what variables affect their formation so that we can come up with intelligent solutions to fix this problem.
The force and the energy of that impact are transmitted to the helmet, to the surface of the helmet. That impact is transmitted through the helmet as a pressure wave or a stress wave. It eventually enters the skull and